We're talking with Alan Rosenblatt, Dr. Digipol on Twitter as part of our social media segment this week. And Alan, as we talk about people claiming either rights to certain hashtags or Twitter addresses or whatnot, it sounds like this is not just an issue of money, although it is a little bit of an issue about money, but it's also, as you pointed out, an issue of credibility, that people, as they collect these things, they then can claim to have more credibility in the activism world. Is that right?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. Twitter provides verified accounts for high-profile people, but you can't really apply for one. It's not true for everybody. And so Twitter doesn't actually enforce who owns at Connect the Left. And as they argue on from Unite Blue is they got that account and switched it. Now, I was following and was followed by Connect the Left early on, and then all of a sudden, the next thing I know, I'm being followed by and following Unite Blue, not by choice, because they were sold this Twitter account that I was already connected to. I have some issues with that. I also have some issues with the evidence that they're supposedly claiming in terms of ownership. The lack of verification. You know, Eileen Left owns the trademark for Connect the Left, but the Twitter handle was in possession of another person who claims that he created the Twitter account and has posted on a Google Doc that's publicly accessible screenshots of emails that he received from Twitter, his confirmation email on August 22nd, 2011, when he allegedly created Connect the Left, and then a follow-up email about people you might be able to connect with on August 30th, 2011. Now, I've created several Twitter accounts for myself and for other people over the last year, several years. And I know that those emails actually arrive on the same day. Now, when you look at Twitter's API, it says that Connect the Left was created on August 23rd, 2011. So neither the first email nor the second email Simon is showing as his evidence arrived to him on the day that the account was actually created according to Twitter's API. And they arrived more than a week apart from each other. Not even exactly a week apart from each other, but 8 days apart from each other. And so in my mind, it's extremely fishy. And you know, it's a developing story, so we don't know where it's going, and we don't know what the truth is, but there's something that really just doesn't smell right here.
And for folks who come up with creative or witty or fast, you know, Twitter handles or Twitter IDs, like, for example, I was impressed that literally within minutes at the State of the Union, there was Paul Ryan after he drank from his bottle of water. There was a Twitter
Marco
handle
Rubio,
that said Ryan's,
yeah.
You know, or Marco Rubio, sorry. Marco Rubio's bottle of water. And, you know, all of a sudden it's got, you know, 40,000 followers, and that's bankable. What should people do in terms of protecting or in terms of making sure that people don't squat on their creativity, particularly in social media?
Well, so since Twitter doesn't afford everybody a verified account, there are ways that you can verify it yourself. When you create a Twitter account, what you should do is on your website, blog or whatever website, you should link to it. Because it's coming from the website that you own, it then you're verifying yourself that this is my Twitter account. And then you do a link on the Twitter account to back to your own website so that there's this loop that connects you to it. That allows you to really control ownership of it. If you're creating a brand like Connect the Left or like Take Action News, you should do some research into trademarking that as well, and make sure that you've been able to do that. Once you've established, once you've established the use of a brand for more than 12 months, it's hard for somebody to sneak in and trademark it or patent or copyright it out from under you. But if it's less than 12 months old and you haven't taken the steps to copyright it or trademark it at the patent trade office, you're at risk. So you need to kind of take some matters into your own hands that way. But certainly the verification loop is really easy to do.
Great stuff as always from Alan Rosenblatt, Dr. Digipol on Twitter. You can follow him there or certainly on Facebook or follow his segments at takeactionnews.com. Alan, great stuff as always. Have a great weekend, my friend.
You too, David. Take care and congratulations on the wedding.
Thank you very much. I'm a married man, everybody. Yes, you heard it here. You've heard it here a couple of weeks. Yes, it was official. Got married 2 weeks ago today. and went off on the honeymoon. And so here it is. You know, there's the ring for everybody who's looking up at YouTube. Amazing. Anyway, we'll continue with Take Action News on the other side of this break with our Activist of the Week. You're listening and watching to Take Action News on We Act Radio.